Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreya Savachay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 13th of October. India records lowest fresh COVID-19 cases in 2 months. Protesters in Pakistan-administered Kashmir oppose move to change Gilgit-Baltistan's status. And historic steps taken for peace, time to reduce violence, says Afghan chief negotiator Abdullah. And now for all the details. India recorded its lowest single-day spike of 55,342 fresh coronavirus cases, nearly half of what the country was reporting around 2 months ago, pushing the cases tally to 71.75 million. Meanwhile, the country's health minister on Tuesday expressed hope that India will have a vaccine for the novel coronavirus by the early next year.
India on Tuesday recorded its lowest single-day spike of 55,342 fresh coronavirus cases, nearly half of what the country was reporting around 2 months ago, pushing the total number of infections to 71.75 million, with 109,856 deaths so far. For the fifth day in a row, active cases have remained below 900,000. Taking the country's recovery rate to 86.8%. India's Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan on Tuesday said India will have a vaccine for the novel coronavirus from more than one source by early next year. Chairing a group of ministers meeting, he expressed hope that by July 2021, 400 to 500 million doses of the vaccine are expected to be made available for 20 to 25 crore people in the country.
We are expecting that early next year, we should have vaccine in the country from maybe more than one source. And our expert groups are already formulating and devising strategies to plan out how do we roll out the distribution of the vaccines in the country.
The health minister also warned people to stay away from large congregations and follow COVID-19 appropriate behavior in view of the upcoming festival and winter season, which pose additional challenges. India imposed a strict nationwide lockdown in March, but has in recent months slowly lifted restrictions amid rising concerns of a sharp slowdown in economic growth.
In news from Pakistan, a special anti-terrorism court in Pakistan has sent the main accused in the motorway gang rape case to a 14-day judicial remand. Over a month after the horrific incident, local police on Monday finally arrested the culprit who had earlier managed to escape from the clutches of law enforcers in at least three previous raids.
An anti-terrorism court in Pakistan's Lahore city on Tuesday sent the prime suspect in the motorway gang rape case, Ahmed Mali, to jail on a 14-day judicial remand. The court also handed over the other suspect in the case, Shafkat, to police on physical remand till October 28. Lahore's Crime Investigation Agency had arrested Abed Mali from Mangda Mandi, approximately 20 miles from the provincial capital. The crime, which had occurred last month, sparked countrywide outrage, in which a mother of two was gang raped off the motorway in front of her children after her car ran out of fuel on the way to Gujranwala late in the night. In the wake of the incident, Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan said he supports public demand and is in favour of public hanging of rapists. His Tehreek-e-Insaf government said it was drafting a law proposing harsher punishment for rapists.
Moving on, a protest was held in Pakistan-administered Kashmir on Monday against Pakistan's proposed move to turn Gilgit-Baltistan into a province and Islamabad's oppressive policies. Anger is mounting high against Pakistan and China over attempts to change legal status of the illegally occupied territory to further exploit its natural resources.
Members of the Save Rivers, Save Muzaffarabad committee in Pakistan-administered Kashmir on Monday held a protest to condemn Pakistan's plan to turn Gilgit-Baltistan into its fifth province. The protesters expressed concern that China has been lobbying Pakistan to bring the illegally occupied region under its legal jurisdiction to protect its investments in Gilgit-Baltistan, which are part of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor or CPEC.
के अंदर पाकिस्तानी मकबूजा गिलगित बल्तिस्तान के अंदर गुज़श्ता कई दहाइयों से वहां पर बदतरीन किस्म के साम्राज्यिक कवानीन लागू हैं. वहां पर पाकिस्तानी नहीं बल्कि चाइनीज फोर्सेस भी बैठी हुई हैं और वो रियासत जम्मू कश्मीर के इस हिस्से को अलग करना चाहती हैं.
The protesters also highlighted the atrocities on Baba Jan and several other political activists in Gilgit-Baltistan who are languishing in jails of Pakistani state and its army. Regular protests have also been witnessed in Gilgit-Baltistan over the proposed move and alleged human rights violations by Pakistani forces to muzzle dissent in the region.
A group of Baloch students have been holding a long march walking from Multan to Pakistani capital Islamabad in protest to demand restoration of reserved seats and scholarships for them in different universities. They blamed that the authorities are trying to convert education, a basic human right, into a luxury for them.
A group of Baloch students have been holding a long march in protest, walking from Multan to Islamabad to demand restoration of reserved seats and scholarships for them in different universities in Pakistan. They have expressed concern that due to educational backwardness in Balochistan, they were earlier provided reservation and scholarships in universities in Punjab province. But now, due to discriminatory policies against Baloch students, they are now unable to afford fees. They blame that the authorities are trying to convert education, a basic human right, into a luxury for them.
We protested against this decision in front of the Bahauddin Zakir University main gate, where we demanded the restoration of these seats, but no one listened us. We took a strict step and decided to march towards Islamabad via Lahore. We have been marching for last 3 days and covered approximately 110 kilometers.
The ethnic Baloch have long alleged that Islamabad has always exploited people from Balochistan. Some of the protesters claimed Pakistan fears an education boom in the youth of Balochistan will be dangerous for their rule.
In news from Afghanistan, Chief Afghan negotiator Abdullah Abdullah has said that historic steps have been taken for peace and the time has arrived to reduce violence in Afghanistan. This comes as peace negotiation efforts between the Afghan government and the Taliban are underway since September in Doha, but no direct talks have started because of disagreements on procedural rules.
Chairman of the High Council of National Reconciliation in Afghanistan, Abdullah Abdullah, on Monday said that historic steps have been taken for peace and the time has arrived to reduce violence in his country. The chief Afghan negotiator, while speaking at the opening ceremony of the Zamzam Foundation, a charity created to support war victims, asserted the Afghan people expect that the peace negotiation talks will reach a conclusion as soon as possible. Other speakers at the event also called for a swift end to the bloodshed and for support of those affected by the war in Afghanistan. Meanwhile, later on Monday, negotiating teams from both the Afghan government and Taliban side held a meeting in Doha, but it ended without an agreement over procedural rules. The meeting follows the involvement of the U.S. Special Envoy for Afghanistan, Zalmay Khalilzad, and envoys of other countries who are supporting Afghan peace.
Moving on to news from Nepal. As virus cases continue to rise at an exponential rate and designated COVID-19 hospitals are unable to cope in Nepal, state-run hospitals in worst-affected Kathmandu Valley will now be converted into COVID-19 facilities. The health ministry has directed all hospitals to postpone elective surgeries to prevent the shortage of intensive care unit beds and ventilators.
Nepal's health ministry has decided to convert all state-run hospitals of the Kathmandu Valley into coronavirus-focused hospitals amid surge in the infection rate and symptomatic cases. According to the ministry, specialty hospitals will now have to keep the patients infected with coronavirus. The ministry has also directed all hospitals to postpone elective surgeries to prevent the shortage of intensive care unit beds and ventilators. Earlier, the authorities had asked infected people to not visit hospitals if their condition is stable and be in isolation in their homes only. Nepal, as of Tuesday morning, had 111,802 confirmed cases of the coronavirus and at least 645 associated deaths. Kathmandu Valley, which comprises of Lalitpur, Bhaktapur and Kathmandu districts, has been contributing the most in the COVID-19 tally of the Himalayan nation.
Authorities in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory have started cleaning the iconic Dal Lake to restore its glory ahead of the winter tourism season amid coronavirus pandemic. Local labourers are being seen carrying out clean-up operation in Dal, thronged by hundreds of tourists from across the world every year.
Authorities in India's Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir have started cleaning the pristine Dal Lake in Srinagar city to make it a pleasant sight for the tourists that are expected to descend into the valley in the coming months as the government has eased coronavirus restrictions. The cleanup operations are conducted every year by the Lakes and Waterways Development Authority to clean the lake polluted of any filth floating on the water and moss and weed growing inside it. Every year, tourists from different parts of India and the world throng the Dal Lake to enjoy rides on the famed Shikara boats. However, the coronavirus pandemic has kept tourists off the valley this year.
आप जब कि टूरिस्ट भी आ रहे हैं यहाँ पर थोड़ा-थोड़ा ये विंटर्स ऑटम सीजन है और हम डल को पूरा ज़्यादा ही साफ करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं रखने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं.
The Kashmir Valley is a popular destination among tourists from across the world, given its Himalayan summits and treks, along with picturesque valleys and lakes.
As the Hindu festival of lights, Diwali, is just round the corner, potters in northern India are cheering after receiving an overwhelming demand of earthen lamps. This year, there is a surge in local-made earthen lamps as Indians are boycotting Chinese products amid border row with China, indirectly boosting business of local potters.
Potters in India's northern Varanasi are busy a bit too early ahead of Hindu festival of lights, Diwali, as they are getting an overwhelming demand for local-made earthen lamps as compatriots boycott Chinese products in the country. The Indian markets have a huge influence of inexpensive Chinese products, especially electronics and plastic items like toys or decoratives, which are even more prominent during the festive season. However, a call for boycotting of Chinese products grew larger in India after a bloody clash in northern Ladakh territory in June this year.
China ka maal aata tha, usme jhalar batti, plastic ka diya jata tha. Ye sab se tab hum log ka koi khich nahi hota tha. Lekin is saal jo hai ki band ho gaya hai China ka maal, isliye diya hua ka jo order mil raha hai, hum log apna उसमें कार्य कर रहे हैं.
हम लोगों का दीपावली पर जो है कि ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा दिया बिकेगा, हम लोगों को इसका जो है कि लाभ मिलेगा. हम लोगों को ये काम करने में अब थोड़ा खुशी है कि चाइना का जो माल था वो बंद होने पर हम लोगों का दिया ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा बिकेगा.
दिवाली, द फेस्टिवल ऑफ लाइट्स, इज सेलिब्रेटेड एवरी ईयर इन अक्टूबर नवम्बर, where Hindus worship and decorate their homes with lamps and lights. It is believed that the Hindu goddess of wealth, Lakshmi, comes to those houses that are well lit and clean.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.